Prefontaine out at the front as he likes to be. They like to see runners with the courage to go out and lead.
It's Prefontaine who may lap somebody before this one's over at the pace that he is going.
See Prefontaine, he's all by himself. And listen to the crowd now as Pre is picking it up. And he has the record in this race. He owns this race.
Every September for the last 36 years, runners from across the U.S. and even the world come to the fishing and lumber town of Coos Bay, Oregon, to honor a man and a memory.
I still get choked up when I'm talking or remembering things about Steve. There are still people that make pilgrimages to Coos Bay in search of his heritage.
To your mark.
They run where Steve Prefontaine used to run. And every year, football players from Marshfield High School, Pre's old school, are waiting at the finish line. Mark Helfrich, class of 92, starting quarterback and now Oregon's head coach, used to be one of those players.
He is bigger today than he was when I was a young kid. Just a tough, progressive guy from a blue-collar background that tried to be different. Certainly the legacy of Steve Prefontaine is amazingly alive and well.
He's the son of Coos Bay, Oregon. That's our guy, and we're Pre's people.
You take pride in that as, oh, I'm from Coos Bay, and so is Steve Prefontaine. The town kind of came alive when my brother started doing his thing.
Pre's thing was simple and primal. Win and inflict pain doing it.
All right.
From Coos Bay, Oregon, Steve Prefontaine.
At Marshfield High, at the University of Oregon, to any opponent or stopwatch that got in his way.
How do you feel? You're number one now.
Well, all I can say is I hope I can stay fit. And if I were going to run like this in Munich, I think I would be pretty hard to top.
He hated the tactics of where people would sit back off your shoulder, then try to outkick you. He hated that. He thought that was chicken shit.
Prefontaine, he said, what I'm going to try to do is work it out so it'll be a pure guts race at the end. And if it is, I'm the only one who can win. He is a superbly confident young man. Some people have said cocky at times. And Steve Prefontaine is going to take the lead. The head down the stretch, coming to the last turn.
There is no holding back in his personality. There is no holding back in his train of thought. It was 100% at all times at everything he did.
And Prefontaine is giving it everything. He's run the whole race in front. Prefontaine sets a new world best time.
Well, I think everybody knew my plan. For me to win a race against competition of that nature, I have to go out hard and just about lead from the start.
Mark Helfrich wasn't even 2 years old on May 30th, 1975, but he knows what that date means. In Coos Bay, everyone knows.
It was the worst day of my life.
Sunday morning, somebody came up to me and said, have you heard the news?
And right now, the little seafaring community of Coos Bay, Oregon, is shrouded in gloom.
I remember getting a phone call from my mother. It was some time after 4:30 in the morning, and my mother was having a hard time getting the words out. I kept asking her, and I kept saying, is it Dad, is it Dad? And when she said, no, it's Steve, and he's dead.
Steve Prefontaine, America's leading long-distance runner, was killed last night in a car accident in Eugene, Oregon. Around midnight, according to police, he was driving alone in a sports convertible. The car jumped the curb, hit an embankment, and flipped over, pinning Prefontaine underneath. He was 24.
I've been up there a few times by myself, but it's just, it's amazing. Every single time you're up there, there's stuff, a token of their appreciation of him.
Prefontaine was gone, but there was something about his legacy that resonated with Helfrich, the athlete, and years later, with Helfrich, the coach.
When I was in college, I used to come up here and run at Hayward Field, and I would always do the, you know, the famous break the tape and look up at the clock and check my time, so to speak. He always checked the clock, and he never looked at his competitors. He never looked at anybody else. He looked essentially against himself. And that's what we try to instill in our guys every single day, is it doesn't matter what everybody else is doing. It matters what you're doing.
The Rose Bowl champions, the Oregon Ducks. And they didn't just win it. They ran away with it.
Free lives everywhere in Helfrich's program. On the sidelines, on his play call sheet, in team meetings.
Our guy's probably sick and tired of hearing about Coos Bay, Oregon, and this runner.
He always jokes like, oh yeah, you know, Steve from my hometown, you know, I taught him how to run or whatever. You saw Steve Prefontaine do, run with passion and run with all the guts and put out all on the field or the track. And I think that's something he kind of tells us and hopes that we do.
Do you have a favorite pre-quote?
Well, I think his most famous one is to give anything less than your best is to sacrifice the gift.
To give anything less than your best is to sacrifice the gift.
Helfrich and Prefontaine never met, but they see each other every day outside Helfrich's office.
That's the beauty of a photo that never grows old. You know, Pre will always be 24 years old. So he lives. He lives as a standard that we try to achieve both as coaches and as athletes.
I think he'd be down on the sidelines. And I think he'd be patting Mark on the back and talking about Coos Bay.
Being from the same hometown, having that connection is something that I think is, for me personally, very special.